Hello everyone, in this video we will learn about message passing as well as producer consumer problem using message passing. So let us start with message passing. So first of all, what actually message passing is? So in this method, mainly there are two types of primitives. First one is send, that is used to send a message. The syntax of send primitive is send in bracket destination comma message. Here destination is the process to which sender wants to send message, and message is what sender wants to send. Second primitive is receive, that is used to receive a message. Syntax is receive bracket source comma message. Here source is the process that has sent the message, as well as message is what the sender has sent. So these are the two primitives of message passing that is used by a process. Now let us move further, the producer consumer problem using message passing. So in this topic, we will execute the algorithm of producer consumer problem using message passing. So let us start the execution. First one is has defined n 100. Here we are defining the value of n as 100 because there are 100 empty slots that are used by a producer and consumer for sending and receiving data. Then after void producer void, this function is called by a producer. Then after integer item, we are declaring a variable that is item to insert or to produce item into it by a producer. Message m, that is a message. While true, while the producer wants to produce some data, this condition becomes true. Now item is equal to produce underscore item. Now here whatever the item that is produced by the producer is first inserted into item variable, then after it is inserted into buffer or it is sent to consumer. So here this producer has generated some item or some data and put it into item variable. Then after receive in bracket consumer comma n% m. Now here whatever the item that is produced by the producer is already there in item, but now that data is to be inserted into that empty slot that is received from consumer. So here this producer will receive the empty slots from the consumer to insert the data into that empty slots and send it to the consumer. So here producer will receive an empty slots from the consumer. Then after build underscore message n% m and item, here producer will construct a message to send it to the consumer. Then after send consumer comma n% m, here the producer will send an item to this consumer having this message or this data. While condition is over and void producer is over. So this function is called by a producer whenever producer wants to produce some data and send it to consumer. Next, void consumer. Void, whenever consumer wants to consume some data from producer, at that time this function is to be called by consumer. Integer, item and I, we are declaring two variable, item as well as I. Then after message m. Now here for I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. So this one is for loop. So n times this consumer is sending an empty slots to the producer, so that producer will send data into that empty slots and send to the consumer. So for that this consumer will send n empty slots to the producer. While true, receive producer comma n% m, here this consumer will get a message that containing the data that is n% m from this producer. So here this consumer will receive a message from this producer having data n% m. Now item is equal to extract underscore item n% m. So here whatever the data that is received from producer is extracted into item variable. Again, once all the item is extracted from this message, this consumer will send an empty slots or empty back to the sender to reply that producer. Once the consumer will extract all the information from that message that is received from producer, that consumer will send an empty reply to the producer to inform that I have received XYZ data. Whatever the item that is extracted and inserted into item variable is now consumed by consumer. While condition is over and void consumer is over. So in this way, producer consumer problem works using message passing. Next one is barrier. Now what actually the barrier is? In this mechanism, all the applications are divided into small parts. And there is one rule that no process can proceed further into next phase until all the process complete its execution in the first phase and are ready to proceed to the next phase. Here we have divided our process into these four subparts, that is A, B, C and D. Here there is one barrier. So these all the process are executing in this phase, that is in first phase. So whenever all the process will complete its execution in this first phase, after that the process is allowed to execute in second phase. So when a process reaches at the barrier, it is blocked until all the process have reached at that barrier. So if we consider these four process, then three process reach at this barrier, but this C process is not reached over here. So A, B and D is not able to execute in next phase until this C process will reach over here. Once this C process will reach over here at this barrier, after that all the process will start its execution in the next phase. That is known as barrier. Thank you very much.